So I'm here with Foreground, and today they're going to show us what they've got here. So what have you got?
Hi, well, this is our Fabled Realms, Legends of Fabled Realms, the game. We started off with this in about 2003. We had our own campaign, and it grew and it grew and it grew. It's been going on for 15 years now?
Yeah.
When we first brought out the Fabled Realms buildings, we actually decided we were going to put the money from the Fabled Realms buildings and put it all towards the one day where we could bring out the game. We've got to that stage now, and so all the homebrew rule system that CAD worked on, you know, they've now become an actual codified set of rules that we're very, very happy with. The buildings work well with it, which is what we're best known for. And Deep Cut Studio is going to be doing some mats for us. So CAD will explain the game, talk maybe about the sculptors and the artists we've got involved. But we're very happy about this. You know, anyway, sorry mate, you carry on.
Yeah, so the game is a fantasy skirmish game for between about 5 to 30 miniatures. We currently have two factions that we're going to Kickstarter with, which are the Eightfold Path and the Dragoi. So the Dragoi are people that are afflicted with a virus. They now crave flesh. Most of them have lost their mental faculties. Some of them have them still, and they get a little bit sad after they've eaten someone.
They go mad.
Yeah, that won't stop them from doing it. So if you imagine somebody that's just had a lot of cake and then afterwards feels guilty, it's a bit like that.
Do you know that feeling?
I do know that feeling. So the Eightfold Path, on the other hand, are a holy militant order.
They don't get cake coma.
They, you would see them potentially as the good guys normally. They protect the world from the evils like the Dragoi and things like that. But to join the Eightfold Path, you can join it because you're very pious. You can also join it because you're about to be executed. You can volunteer.
Think French Foreign Legion.
Yeah. Yeah, like the Night's Watch as well. And the what you do is, once you've joined, you can take upon you the blood of the Dragoi. If you do that, you can do that through drinking it or through scarifying yourself and then rubbing it all over you. You then ascend, and you're no longer bound by mortal laws. Now, if you're a murderer or a thief and you join and you become ascended and you're no longer bound by mortal law...
Other than the Eightfold Path codes.
Yeah. So what then happens is you go into a village and you go, "I like the gold you've got here." The villagers go, "Well, we don't want to give you the gold." And he goes, "Well, I think one of you's turning unless I get the gold, and then if you're turning, I kill your village." So they're not necessarily the good guys. Well, not all of them anyway.
And the way they take all the gold, well, they take something back to the commandery with them. Not necessarily all the gold.
So some of it may go missing on the way.
But other factions have different ons, different reasons for doing it. Like, the Dragoi, for instance. Totally different desire in a legacy game as to what they're after,
So what you've also got is, the way the game plays is, normally you have, in a lot of games, you have I go, you go, or alternate activation. Now what we've got is an action reaction mechanic. So you have a pool of ability action points, which is called your momentum pool. And the way it would work is, as an example, if you've got two miniatures where one of them's a wizard and one of them's a character that's very good in combat, the wizard obviously wants to shoot the character in the face. Character doesn't want to get shot in the face, and if he's close enough, he can declare that he's going to charge the wizard. Now, what will then happen is you have a roll off using the custom dice, and if you're successful as the guy with the swords, the wizard's not going to get to shoot you. You're going to charge him in the face and cut him down.
Yeah.
If you're successful as the wizard, you shoot him in the face, and if he doesn't die, he still charges you and cuts you down.
But sometimes you want to react first so you can get out of it as well.
Yeah, you can run away, you could hope that one of your friends jumps in the way.
The game is coming out with plastic miniatures in the box.
Yeah.
For those people who want resins, there will be slightly larger resins that will be available afterwards for people. Hopefully we've covered all the bases. Also, with Legacy Games, we've designed it so that if just one member of your club is wanting to play Legacy and the others just want to play standalone games, then there's a way they can drop into that person's actual game, play against them, and then that person can still carry on with their Legacy game. So hopefully we've covered all the angles as gamers for what people would want. Anyway, yeah, we've got two factions already done. We've got another two factions that, if the Kickstarter goes well, will be coming out during the Kickstarter. And then there's another two factions that will be coming out a bit later on after the Kickstarter. It's hopefully going to be a game that also retailers want to get on board with. So we're doing things like, there's retailer pledges, but with a lot of the miniatures that are coming out as the exclusives for the Kickstarter, there will be a different pose for that guy for the retailers. So they will still get all the cards to play the game. It will still work for retailers to play the game, and we'll support them the way we always have with everything
they're
else.
Exclusive sculpts, not exclusive packs.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right then, thanks very much.